now on BBC One, This'll Take You Back. Jim Davidson's reminiscing amongst the cuddly toys and conveyor belts.
Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. We're so glad you could attend. Come inside, come inside. There behind the glass stands a real blade of glass. Careful as you pass, move along, move along. Come inside, the show's about to start. Guaranteed to blow your head apart. Rest assured, you'll get your money's worth. The greatest show in heaven, heaven. Gotta see the show.
Thank you. Well, hello out there, long-time TV viewers. Sit up and pay attention, because I want to ask you a question. Where were you on the night of October the 2nd, 1971? Yes, think about that. I know where I was. I was coming home from work. In those days, I was a budding comic by night, and a day job, I used to wring out a chamois leather for a one-armed window cleaner. On this particular night, I came home to our little council house in Kibbrook, where our whole family was sitting in the front room watching a show on TV. We had one of them 12-inch black and white jobs. You know, you can almost get a good picture if you held the portable aerial in your hand and stood on a chair, facing east. Now, let's face it, there weren't much to choose from in those days, were there? One channel had those little piggy puppets, Pinky and Perky. Another channel had the Avengers, Kinky and Quirky. So what was everybody watching on that fateful Saturday night? Only the first transmission of the Generation Game, that's all.
Life is the name of the game, and I want to play the game with you.
Thank you. Thank you. Good evening. Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, children. Welcome to the Generation Game. Nice to see you. To see you. And Phoebe, when you come in here, your first line is at the back of the door. When you get your cigarette, your line is written on the cigarette. You read it off the cigarette, and the last line you do, the cigarette's in the cigarette box, dear.
Right, you need those.
Does she need those?
French mate, the glasses on.
All right, wear your glasses, dear.
What
do
I read?
No, well,
I can't see anything if I put them on now.
Oh, I see. You've got to. Have we really got research people on this show? French maid who's called Daphne and blind as a bat. Anyway. I can't believe that was back in 1971, can you? When the whole world was singing songs about some of the girls I was going around with at the time. Sweet Caroline, Bridget the Midget, Crackling Rosie, and not to mention Amazing Grace. She was amazing. And could she say great? Anyway, as you must have guessed by now, this is a timely tribute to your favourite family fun show that's brought us some wonderful moments over the years. Yes, this is the Generation Game 30 years on, nearly, with modern technology, which means we have all different cameras everywhere over the studio so I can talk to whoever I want, even that little one up there. So... We've had them all there. Morris dancing with little bells on their britches, tinkling all over the floor. Old-time ballroom dancers. The Gay Gordons. Oh, yes. Where are those lads now? And how can we ever forget the night the contestant with a wooden leg did a quick pirouette with Wayne Sleep and screwed herself into the stage? Hey! Had to dance around the other way to get her home. Anyway, these were great moments. And here are some more. Cop the clothes on some of the contestants. On you come, then. The first one.
I think he's had a few too many here.
What's his name?
Get Footy, come on.
What's his name?
idea. That's it. I like your mother.
Phyllis, there's another Phyllis here.
All right, then. Jolly good.
I don't like being called Phyllis. Oh, you don't? My name's Phil with a Y.
Phil with a Y. All right, darling. Oh, a bit like that. There's another bundle of trouble. Right. OK, Phil with a Y. It's Phil Cole. It's mother and son. You're from Derby. And you are a canteen assistant at the local police station. Oh. Do you take truncheon vouchers?
Truncheon vouchers. Straight in the pocket for them.
All right, love. Fine. She's got an answer every time, this one. Left her pocket. Right. You... I'm only coming to keep you quiet. Once when, on a visit to Bellevue Zoo, a gorilla took a fancy to you. Oh, what a thrill, Phil. What did it do to you, dear?
Oh, it pulled me air and they had to fetch the
Oh, well, that's a relief. What?
It fetched the zookeeper. It wouldn't let me air. It wanted to get me in there.
Oh, really?
Wish he had.
Hotel Bertie dear, there's another room like six along the corridor.
Oh, another room six. So that's it.
I've left my suitcase back there. You'd better get it.
Who?
I'll change for dinner.
Right, old dragon. Right. I'm the star. All right, mate. I'm the star of the show. What a rotten farce.
Excuse this intrusion, is this the Old Bailey?
Shut up, give us a chance.
Ah, Mr. Forsyth, are you the QC? Just call me Brucey.
The court will rise.
All rise, all rise. To see you nice.
All rise
to see you nice.
Of old Jim well, especially the familiar cry of the old rooster.
I don't
know. Oh, attack me, attack me. Go on.
You're spying! What do you think you're...
You speak in German! You're spying! You're spying! Five, four. Right, okay. I knew we shouldn't have done this. Right, here we go. Right, and five.
Well, it didn't take long for Bruce to turn this show into a regular Forsyth saga. And when he left, they found a perfect replacement, lovable Larry. Yes, the great Larry Grayson. He's up there now, of course, ladies and gentlemen, in that big camping ground in the sky. I can see him now giving one of his looks to St. Peter at the Golden Gate and telling him to shut that door.
Shut that door.
Sorry, Larry, you do it better than me.
Shut that door and enjoy the generation game. Larry Grayson is here to play so.
Shut that door.
Now let's turn to you, Larry.
No, John.
John. I've got the wrong card. No, don't. No, don't. No, they'll cut it. No, what a gay day. I say, by the way, I know your face ever so well. You love anything that's old?
Yes.
We should pass over that, and I shall pretend that you never did that. And it said... Don't worry, I'm not going to spit. And it said it here.
It's because Chung Ling doesn't speak only very little English. And Tony is like his...
Interpreter.
Interpreter, that's right, interpreter. So, welcome to the show. Tell him.
Tell him. Tell him.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, yeah. No. Very good. Yes. Has he been over here very long?
Well, yes, roughly 32 years.
No. Oh, he can't be that old. I thought he was just a boy.
No, no.
Tell him what I said. Tell him what I said. Tell him.
佢話咧，你真係好似個細路仔咁啊！
多謝。哎，我今年有兩個細路仔啦。Two boys.
I think he's cute. What did you say to me?
Well, he said he has got two children.
Oh, has he?
Yeah.
He's killed it. All right. On a holiday some time ago, is that right? You went on a holiday. You didn't go on a holiday at all, did you? No, actually, I've just got a message coming through. You are going on a holiday. Yes. Yes. Yeah. I got out of that all right, didn't I? Oh dear. Good for you, Lau. He said you want to spend a whole month carefully training a climbing rose to twirl around your pergola.
Yes.
Why was I given this piece of information?
I can't wait to see this.
Did you ever see Lou Ayres in All Quiet on the Western Front? Okay, we'll do it.
Okay.
Just a minute. Just a moment. Just a moment. There is no need to shout. Speak. Tell him what I'm like.
No, you can't take being shouted at.
No, you mustn't shout. She'll tell
very
you.
Gentle.
I'm a very gentle man. Shut your mouth. I'm a very gentle man. I will do anything you ask if you ask me properly, but if you start shouting and bawling, I will not do a thing. She told you. Tell him.
That's right. He won't do it. I know.
Please, Damon Grayson. Buy the ripple, please.
Yeah, all right. And don't forget to write. You can go back there now, Flash.
Final rope! Evan Grace McJordan, please.
What?
Put your hands on your side, please. Oh.
You said it, you said, put your hand on your side, and I did it, didn't I?
Power! Huh.
You're married to Albert.
Yeah.
Albert and Wynne. Could be the start of a film. Albert and Wynne, twice nightly. And, you what, love?
You... I said he should be so lucky.
What a pretty... Wynne, you are cheeky. You're not a Devon dumpling, are you?
And children, welcome to the Generation Game. It's nice to see you, to see you. Yes. And do you know, it's been 13 years since I last did the Generation Game. And I was so flattered when the BBC asked me to come back to do it. You know, but all the pleading and the begging and the grovelling. Oh, I hope I didn't belittle myself. Thank you. Oh, sorry, sorry. You'll get your chance. Oh, so soon.
Give him the bucket, shall we? Give him the bucket, shall we? Give him the bucket. Give him the bucket, shall we? Good boy. Good boy. Yeah, we'll have some biscuits after, Shane. Shane, up here. You can have the bucket on here. Have the bucket. Have the bucket up here. Yes. Have the bucket up here, Shane.
Get your whipped cream. Get your whipped cream and put it on the top. The whipped cream in the top. Trixie, will you stop? I wouldn't mind two more payments in his mind.
It does say something here about a duck face. Would you like to see that?
Macy.
Was it?
Or Macy.
Sorry. Okay, could you put her in a room, sir? So good to your nicknames are Mick Jagger. Why do they call you Mick Jagger?
Because
you've got a big mouth, yes. And Jumbo. Why do they call you Jumbo? Yes, well, maybe you better not tell us.
Oh,
handsome hunk today.
I'm very well, thank you, Rosie.
Fire! Fire!
Hey, hold on. For God's sake. Like a ginger Tom.
Go on, a few bats.
Keep opening it and shutting it. Look. It's a very old bat. No, I wasn't calling you an old bat.
Our name is Carnes.
He's Bert
and I am.
Oh, what?
Pardon?
Just a minute.
Close the door.
That's it. You can all go home if you like. No, you don't read it, dear. They do the reading. You just do this bit.
Fetch me one of my pills, will you?
Boogie 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 Boy of Company B.
A tootly, a tootly, motivated the bar. In boogie rhythm, you count power note, let the bass and guitar is playing with him. He makes the company jump when he plays reveille. He's the boogie woogie boogie boy of Company B. Woo!
Night and makes them act the same way in the early bright. They clap their hands and stamp their feet because they know how he plays when someone gives him a beat. He makes the company jump when he plays reveille. He's the boogie woogie boogie boy. Company B, the boogie woogie boogie boy. Company B.
It's a tradition that every Gen Game host has an attractive female sidekick. Larry had Isla, Brucey had Anthea and Rosie, and I had Sally Mean, remember Sally from the first series? And Melanie Stace, with a photogenic face. What a bunch of Bonnie Punter shunters. I'll say that again. I won't bother. And they all had such fun on the show, didn't they? Especially Mel.
I tell.
I must own up, the old Gen game completely changed gear when Mighty Bruce got replaced by a quivering bloke. Me. Yes, I took over. I was really chuffed when the BBC asked me to host this ancient British institution, because they said that's where I belonged. In an institution. You know, I was so nervous on that first night, I tell you, I was shaking like a jelly in a railway dining car. Think of it. Hey? What a responsibility for me. A bit weird, really, because I was taking control of a show I've loved ever since I was a little... Well, not a little kid, but since I was very young. And over the last few years, me and my talented crew have brought a bit of radical new look to the old show. I mean, anything can happen. And the screen is awash with slosh.
Costume! Music!
Thank you.
Malfunction, malfunction, wedding, malfunction, malfunction. Malfunction, cannot compute, malfunction, overload. Right, we need someone to take the picture now. Norman, the cameraman. Norman, don't drop it, it costs a fortune. Right, OK, you get in, I'll take it. You get in, you get in, you get in. Hang on a minute, an error has crept in. We haven't got any confetti. What can we use instead of confetti?
Rice!
Rice! Okay, right, cue the rice! Kiss!
You got close family?
Yes,
yeah, got a picture of you and your sisters here, are they?
Oh, right.
Is that your sister?
Yeah.
Which is your sister?
The little one, Iris.
Oh, she's lovely. Where's she now?
She's at home in Newport.
Is she?
Yeah.
Oh, lovely. Do you see her very often?
Yes. Yeah.
Apparently you used to do tap dancing with her.
Yes.
Did you really?
That's what we were doing there. Yeah,
yeah, you're a good tap dancer.
Well.
You'd have a little go, wouldn't you? Will you give us a little go? Stand over there then. And give us a little go. Okay, bit of 42nd Street. Here we go.
Okay.
What's your name?
Maite.
Do you think I could have a little go of that?
Too? Yeah.
What do I do?
Wiggle.
Wiggle.
Yep.
Go on then.
There we go.
You've done it all. You've broken every code. Paul the rebel to the floor.
Totally immobilised now, I can't move that at all. Am I now? All right. Okay. In the boat. All right. Will you come back and do some marking?
We shall indeed.
Thank you. Mary.
Yeah.
You've got a bucket of water. If you don't throw that water
over
me, I promise.
All right, Jim. I won't really throw this bucket of water over you. Right, lads!
Gentlemen, It's games like this one here that actually, you know, spell out why this show is called The Generation Game. Because you look at the embarrassment on the young people's faces. As a generation away, Dad is making a complete burk of himself.
What am I gonna do to make you love me? What am I gonna do to make you care? What am I gonna do when lightning strikes me?
I am actually a spot welder, by the way. This camera's
oh,
now
course
just
you are.
A sham.
Oh, yes,
I'm
yes.
just desperate to be in TV, you know, so I've got this. A gorgeous espadistra leaf, are you?
That's an espadistra leaf.
Espadistra leaf. Now, took
Is
it in.
Is that supposed to be an impression of me?
No, love, it's not. No, took it in. And then your other espadistra leaf.
Go,
fold it in like that. Really good. Governor. And then fold it under like that. Now, me.
What's this? This
Now then.
There may be trouble ahead, but while there's moonlight and music and love and romance, let's face the music and dance.
This is like sort of like glue or what? Is this ordinary?
It's amazing.
Who needs glasses? Oh, sorry, I do beg your pardon. Get me own, I don't care, I'll bring me own in.
Smooth up again.
Your shirt's hanging out. Is that trendy, isn't it?
Jacket's got to be open, though.
Not going to open me jacket, never mind about that. He's quite a sports man. He likes you're into motorbikes, yep. Right? And manly sports, football, rugby. What's his main hobby?
It's cake decorating.
Cake decorating?
What's it?
Why cake decorating?
Well, make the little flowers and things on the cakes.
You mean you cook cakes yourself?
No, no, the missus cooks the cakes. I do the flower decorating on the top.
Oh,
I can see clearly now the rain is gone. I can see all obstacles in my way. Gone are the dark clouds that had me blind. It's gonna be a bright, bright, sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright, bright, sunshiny day.
Look at me, the star of the show. Carl, can you come and clean me off? Thank you, Carl. I must speak to that boy. These are nice, aren't they? Chilies, love them.
You might try some of this. Mm. Oh, God, a bit hot, isn't it? You try some of this and I try some... nice and spicy.
I'm sailing, I am sailing on again across the sea. I am sailing. Stormy waters to be with you, to be free. I am flying, I am flying across the sea. I am
a lot of our contestants are game for a laugh, and we've had a lot of laughs in the games. Do you know you can get help?
Thank you.
don't know when I went in the house. Oh, seventh fridge.
Now, the Gen Game's been on for years and years and years and years, and nothing ever goes wrong.
I think
and you could put that in a window with confidence.
Oh, yes. Yes.
You could put it in a window with confidence. Oh, God. You see, I will interfere. I wish I were dead. No, wait a minute.
Thank you.
That's good.
Thank you very much. I thought I felt a bit of a draft there.
The show so far.
Open the doors.
Show her in!
Duck, 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 duck. Heads will roll! His string's broke.
Now, wait a minute.
Nice icicles. Yeah.
Yes.
You and didn't do that at the run through, did you?
How did you know? You weren't here.
Oh. Oh, sorry.
You're married to Edwin. Oh, no, you're married... We all make mistakes.
Well, folks, that's the Gen Game, a show that's been running for so long. When it first came on, the stuff they were showing on the Antiques Roadshow was new. Why has it run so long? I don't know, you tell me. I'll tell you something for nothing. It's probably because it's one of those few shows on TV today where the whole family can sit and watch, like my family did all those years ago in Kibrook. Yes, you won't get any of that spicy foreign stuff they show on satellite and Channel 4. The only mucky turn you'll ever see on this show is the potter's wheel. Yes, Mrs. So this has been a tribute to two great comedians, Bruce and Larry, and a show it's been great for me to be associated with. Long may it run. And keep watching, folks, because you ain't seen nothing yet. Believe me.
It's so important to make someone happy. Make just one someone happy. Make just one heart-to-heart you. You sing to love is the answer. Someone to love is the answer. Once you've found her, build your world around her. Make someone happy. Make just one someone happy, and you will be happy too.
Jim Davidson's Generation Game, Saturday 6:35 on BBC One.